Hey everyone, I'm Brooklyn and it's time for another school newscast. College and Career Readiness Week is coming up soon here at the high school, but starting next week, door decorations will be going on during advisory classes. So plan on decorating your posters and doors using the theme of Career and College Ready. Doors will be judged on Monday, September 26th, and the winning class will get to have a pizza party during their advisory period. Seniors, if you're interested in attending Manufacturing Day at the Industrial Park in Poplar Bluff on October 7th, please sign up and get a permission form in the counseling office or with Ms. Fish at the Career Center. Manufacturing Day will give students the opportunity to learn more about the manufacturing industry, career choices, and take a plant tour. Today's the last day to sign up for the trip. A rep from Arkansas State University will be here on September 21st during advisory to speak with interested students. Sign up with the counselors if you would like to attend. As some of you may or may not know, there are 5 foreign exchange students here at the high school this year. 3 of the students are from Spain and 2 are from Germany. Many exchange students sign up to explore new cultures and traditions, learn a new language, and get a chance to travel the world. We caught up with some of our students this week and asked them about their experience so far.
I want to improve my English and make new friends.
A new culture and a new language.
I think almost everything is good, but it's different for me, the food and all this stuff.
The students we spoke with say that their experience has been great so far and that it does help to have other foreign exchange students in the same school to talk to. The softball team is selling tickets for a loaded baked potato and salad lunch to help raise money for a new locker room and concession stand at the softball field. Tickets are $8 and the lunches will be delivered on September 28th. The team will deliver anywhere within the city limits and to Gatewood and Lone Star schools. See any softball player or Coach Eddington to get your ticket. And finally, band students will be taking part in the parade in Maynard on Saturday. Students need to meet at the band building by 8:15 and the bus will leave at 8:30. Here's Tim with this week's club news and announcements.
Thanks, Brooklyn. A reminder that Skills USA is currently taking applications for members. To become a member, students can sell 24 tickets for the trailer being built by the welding class, or they can pay $20 to become a member. You must be a member in order to compete in Skills USA events later this year. Also, Skills USA held their officer installation Tuesday night. This year's president is Mikkel Boone, and the vice president is Jacob Fisher. Project Graduation is starting its first fundraiser for the year. Seniors will be selling 5-gallon buckets of laundry detergent, fabric softener, and dish soap, and more for only $45 per bucket. If you'd like to purchase one or want more information, see any senior. They are also hosting a formal wear sale this Saturday between 1 and 4 o'clock in the elementary cafeteria. If you have a formal dress or man suit you would like to sell, please bring it in between 11 and 12. It must be priced and have your name on it. Finally, there will also be a project grad meeting for parents and students on Tuesday at 6 o'clock in the high school cafeteria. SCCLA is looking for new members. The dues are $10 and it's open to all students. If you'd like more information, please see its club sponsor, Ms. Hodo. In other club news, if you're interested in joining Pep Club, you need to see Ms. Thor and pay your dues of $15. Paying your dues will provide you a shirt and will get you into all home games at no charge. Also, all students are invited to join SCA. You do not have to be an athlete to join. Dues are $15 and include your club t-shirt. Dues can be paid to Miss Andrew Fowler in the Great Expectations Cafe. Here's Devlin with this week's sports.
Thanks, Tim. It was a busy week in sports, so we're going to jump right in, starting with baseball. The baseball team traveled to East Carter on Tuesday and lost that game by a score of 10-1. They will play Campbell here at home tonight. That game will start at 4:30. The softball team had 2 games this week. First on Monday, they traveled to Twin Rivers and lost that game by a score of 10-2. On Tuesday, they were on the road again to East Carter and also lost that game by a score of 7-1. Today, they travel again for a game with Dora. The volleyball team had a game here at home on Tuesday against Clearwater, and you missed a good match if you weren't there. After losing the first set of the night, the Donettes rallied in the second set and won the third set to defeat the Tigers. Up next for the Donettes is a tournament this weekend at Clearwater and a game here at home on Thursday against Kennett. Here's Rachel for this weekend's weather forecast.
Thanks, Devlin. Looks like the first part of the weekend will be stormy, with scattered thunderstorms on Saturday and a high of 85. Sunday, a small chance of more storms and 84. Things will dry out on Monday, mostly sunny and 86. Coming up next week on the newscast, football is back after more than 30 years. We caught up with the team and coaches and spoke to them about the season and plans for the future years. That's going to do it for this newscast. Thanks for joining us, and we'll see you again next week.